to you, my darlings. Happy New Year. Want to wish you a happy and blessed and prosperous and fulfilling new year in 2024. Every year, I seek the Lord for a word for me, for you guys. And the word this year is to order your steps. Order my steps in your word. Oh Lord, from Psalms 119 and 133. How many of you know we need the Lord to order our steps? Order our steps, oh Lord, in your ways and in your path. Because he's the one that holds our lives in his hands. Let me go on over to the Bible. Psalm 119, 133. Order my steps in your word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. And the Lord gave me that word yesterday morning, and I've been praying it. I've been writing it in my journal, in my moments of gratitude journal. You could get yours on Amazon. I think it's on sale. And I've been writing what I need the Lord to order my steps in. Okay. I was up early this morning praying. I just got up from kneeling down praying and asking the Lord to order my steps, my family's steps, your step in his word. So I will take a few minutes this morning and go over this word. And I hope that you will receive this word. And I hope that in 2024, that the Lord will order your steps and he will order your word, your ways. This is probably going to be one of the only videos you get from me this week, because I'm going to take the rest of this week off. You know, I usually like to just spend some time meditating and praying and seeking the Lord and so on and so forth. So this you'll get today, and I might do that Shirley Strawberry video. I know a few of you emailed me that you needed me to get this one done today. I don't think it's going to be today, girl. You know, they're stressing me out. And of course, be sure to check out Study Your Bible in 1 Year, How to Read Your Bible in 1 Year. I will be doing Bible reading over there. Hopefully I can get it done today, but if not, I'll get that done tomorrow. But I absolutely love you. And meditate on this word about ordering your steps, having the Lord order your steps in his way. Okay, let's go to one. Let's just make it one Psalm, Psalm 119. So I can read some of the other scriptures if I need to. And so for those of you who want to know how to study the Bible and how, because it's Sister Janice, get to know the Bible, I'm going to show you how. This is a perfect example for you to learn how to study your Bible and how to meditate on the scriptures. Be sure to subscribe, thumbs up, share this out for me. I absolutely love you and I adore you. So Psalm 119, I will be reading, and I will be doing my Bible reading this year from the New King James Version of the Bible. The last time I did it from the King James Version of the Bible, but this year I will be doing it from the New King James. I was raised up on the KJV. I like the KJV. I understand it. I know how to flip the words around like thee and thou and thus in my mind, but some people don't. So this here from the New King James Version, Psalm 119 and 33, it says here, direct my path. Let me put this up. But let's go back and read from 119, because that's how it have it broken up. And make this the New King James Version. New King James Version. There we go. Okay, good. It has it broken up in the way it's in the Bible. So I can read from here. Okay. pi, 119. Psalm 119 and 129. Your testimonies are wonderful. Therefore, my soul keeps them. The entrance of your words gives light. It gives understanding to the simple. I opened my mouth and panted, for I long for your commandments. Look upon me and be merciful to me, as your custom is toward those who love your name. Direct my steps by your word, and let no iniquity have dominion over me. Redeem me from the oppression of man, that I may keep your precepts. Make your face shine upon your servant, and teach me your statutes. Rivers of water run down from my eyes, because men do not keep your law. 113, direct my steps by your word, and let now no iniquity have dominion over me. That's the New King James Version. Let me read the King James Version for you. Verse 119 and verse 33. Order my steps. Let's make this a little big so we can compare. There you go. Order my steps in thy word, and let not iniquity, any iniquity, have dominion over me. Now, this has a reference, and the reference is B. So the reference for B is Psalm 117, Psalm 17 and 5. This is how you study the Bible. Y'all talk about studying the Bible. So let's see what that reference is. This is a reference Bible I have here. Verse Psalm 17 and 5 says, hold up my goings in thy path, that my footsteps slip not. So the reference here for Psalm 119 and 133, Psalm 17 and 5, hold up my goings in your path, that my footsteps slip not. Let's see, does it have another reference here? It also has Romans 6 and 19. Let's see what Romans 6 and 19 says. Romans 6 and 19 says, I speak after the manner of men because of the infirmity of your flesh. For as he have yielded your members servant to uncleanness and to iniquity unto iniquity, even to now yield your members servants to righteousness unto holiness. So that kind of goes back to talking about in verse 33, direct my steps by your word, and let no iniquity have dominion over me. Let's go on over. I have another Bible. We talk about studying the Bible, right? One verse. This one verse. This is one of my parallel Bibles. And in this version, I have the New King James, the NIV, the New Living Translation. I don't really mess with the NIV, but let's see what the NIV says. Psalm 119 and 133. Direct my footsteps according to your word. Let no sin rule over me. So in 2024, Lord, direct my footsteps according to your word, and let no sin rule over me. That's the NIV. Let's see what the New Living Translation says. Verse 33, guide my steps by your word, so I will not be overcome by evil. Guide my steps by your word, so that I will not be overcome by evil. I have another parallel Bible. Come on, students. This is how we study the Bible. In this parallel Bible, it has the King James Amplified, New Living Translations, the NIV. I will read the Amplified and the New American Standard. We already King James and NIV. Psalm 119 and verse 33. From the Amplified Version, establish, come on somebody, establish my steps and direct them by means of your word. Let not any iniquity have dominion over me. New American Standard Version says, establish my footsteps in your word, and do not let any iniquity have dominion over me. Now, I know what the word iniquity means, but maybe you don't. So, Strong's Concise Concordance and Vine's Dictionary. Let's see what the word iniquity means. Okay, for those of you who want to study the Bible and you want to get it done in a day, it don't take. You see how long we're spending on one verse just to have an understanding of what this one verse is talking about. Ooh, and these words are tiny. Yes, Lord, iniquity. Ooh, child, let's go to the Bible dictionary. Bible dictionary, iniquity. What does that mean? What does the word Bible dictionary online? King James, iniquity, N-I-Q-I-T-Y, iniquity. What does the word iniquity mean? Iniquity. Iniquity. What does it mean? Let's see, according to the King James Bible Dictionary, the word iniquity. Injustice, unrighteousness, a deviation from rectitude, as the iniquity of war, the iniquity of the slave trade. Want of rectitude in principle, as a malicious prosecution, originality in the iniquity of the author. A particular deviation from rectitude, a sin of crime, wickedness, any act of injustice. Your iniquities have separated between you and your God. So, I can't find my Vine's dictionary. So, here we see it means any deviation from righteousness. Let not iniquity, any deviation from righteousness. What does righteousness mean? It means right standing with God. So if this is not what God is saying for my life and in my life, let not that have dominion over me. That's why I laugh at people, you know, when they come over here, you know. But another definition of the word iniquity, I can't find my Vine's dictionary, is sin to the bone, right? And in another part of scripture where it came to King David, as a matter of fact, in Psalm 119, he talks about not letting iniquity have dominion over him and forgiving him of iniquities. That means he has sinned to the bone. And if you know the story of David, David had sinned to the bone, which is why there was so much sin in his bloodline. So sometimes there are things in our lives, iniquity in our lives, in our family, in our bloodline, that can have control or dominion over us. And David is saying, let not iniquity, Lord, have dominion over me, but instead order my steps in your word. So my question to you, beloved, is what is God saying to you, or what has God said in his word to you about you? What has God said about your salvation of your household and your children and your family? What has God said about your finances? You know, I was chuckling this morning of one of the most popular posts you see on Facebook is, oh, God is going to put money in your bank account. Do you know how many people is waiting for God to miraculously put money in their bank account instead of working the principles that God has given us in the Bible? First thing is you bring your tithes and offering to you the storehouse. You work hard. You pray God to give you wisdom and knowledge and understanding. God has given me wisdom and knowledge and understanding over our finances that I have, with the wisdom and knowledge and understanding that God has given me, that I have multiplied my husband and I finances, our savings, our investments. I have multiplied those by the wisdom and the knowledge and understanding of God. Yet there are people that still waiting and praying for God to put miraculously put money in their bank account. Order my steps in your word, O Lord. Direct my steps, direct my path. What has God spoken to you that has not come to pass in your life? The Lord reminded me about a dream I had 3 years ago. I had a dream that my husband got a new job and he was making this amount of money. And it was a lot more than what he was making. And he was like, oh no, that's a really bad, that's what, you know. And the Lord brought that dream back to me. And he said, that dream is stuck in the spiritual realm. As a matter of fact, let me show you how the Lord showed me. See, the enemy, he has a whole lot of our prayers held up. He got a whole lot of our prayers. He got this, the devil. He got our prayers held up. Because God said, when we pray, he gives it to us. He answers us in the book of the Apostle John. When we pray, we should know that God hears us. But what happened is God released them, and the devil, he got our blessings. He got your husband held up. He got mine. Yeah, I had my. He got your money, your wisdom, your finances, your health, your house. I know we like to talk about, oh, y'all preachers like to talk about blab it and grab it. No. But some people are believing God for houses. We are believing God for a house. And we're just sitting here waiting because the interest rate is so high. But the interest rate is going down. And a lot of you, God has your blessings. The devil have your blessings held up. And you know what I saw? I saw going through our houses and praying and praising God and pleading the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And all of a sudden, I just see blessings start dropping because the enemy has our blessings held up. So in 2024, God says he wants us to stay on this scripture about ordering my steps, God, directing my path, that whatever you need God to do in your life, you need to write it down in your Moments of Gratitude journal on Amazon. And every day you need to go over there and pray and bind the devil. Okay, I got stuff written down in here. We find our forever home. I know that I need to pray some more. I know that I need to publish some more books. I am believing God to give us wisdom to grow our investment portfolio. I am praying the blessings and the manifestation of God and blessing on my family, my children. I'm believing God to move some things around in my family. I'm believing God to work some stuff out. I am believing God to give me wisdom for my courses. So whatever it is that you've been believing God for that has not manifested, you need to every day, Lord, order my steps in your way. You need to every day pray and believe God and speak what thus saith the Lord. A lot of you ladies are waiting for husbands and you just sitting around waiting for God to bring him. Ma'am, you're 85. You's 85 years old. It's the same thing as people sitting down waiting for God to put money in their bank account versus getting up praying God to give you wisdom, work your gifts. What are your gifts? He said that your gift will make room for you and bring you before great men. So not only will your gift, David, bring you, make room for you and bring you before great men, King Saul, but your gift will bring in the money that you need. David went from a 17-year-old poor boy to a 17-year-old multi-millionaire in one day. Hallelujah. Why? God didn't miraculously put money in his bank account, but God gave him the wisdom and the understanding and directed his path, directed his way, and God used David's gift to make that boy a multi-millionaire. King Saul said, whoever killed Goliath will get my daughter's hand in marriage. His family will be exempt from taxes, and I will make him a very rich man in one day. So a lot of you are sitting there waiting for God to do, bring the man to you, bring the husband, bring the house, bring the money, versus you praying, God, order my steps. Give me the wisdom, the knowledge, and understanding that I need. Give me the wisdom to write these books. Give me the wisdom for these courses. Give me the knowledge and the understanding to move my investments around for growth and increase. Some of you are like the five foolish virgins. You're just sitting around waiting versus up getting up and go getting you some oil. Some of you ladies wanting God to bless you with a husband, and you're sitting in the house walking around in big, sweaty, stinky t-shirt. Here's a mess. You're not dressing up. You're not going out. You're not putting yourself out there like Ruth. You're not being Rebecca. You're not being Rachel. You're being the ugly girl Leah at home that her daddy Laban had to scam Jacob into marrying her. So if you, whatever you're believing God for in 20 and 24, you need to do what? Order my steps. It didn't say stay in one place. Step, meaning you're moving. You are moving. You're doing something about what you need God to do. Huh? I am believing God to grow my YouTube channel. So guess what I do? I get up every morning and I come on YouTube. I'm believing God to increase my writing and make my book number one bestsellers all over the world. So guess what I do? I get up earlier and I spend some time writing and praying and putting my books out there and tell people about my books and sharing my books. See, you have to give God something to work with. Come on, the prophet Elijah and the woman with a little bit of flour that she said, me and my son, we just have this little bit of flour and we go eat this little bit of food and we gonna die. And the prophet came and said, well, make me a cake first. And that woman stepped out on faith. God ordered her steps. And she made the prophet a cake. If it today in 23, it would be a YouTube channel. We'll be talking about the pastor who went on over there and ate the old widow woman food. And she made the cake for the prophet. And the prophet now says, no, go ahead and borrow some bottles and stuff and pour your oil and flowers. She didn't just open the thing and there was flour. She had to plant a seed. And sometimes the seed is wisdom. For me, the seed for me is what give me the wisdom, God. Give me the wisdom and the knowledge and the understanding that I need to plant the seed so you can increase the seed. So in 20 and 24, my brothers and my sisters, God wants to order your steps. Put your house in order. Put your finances in order. Put your family in order. Put your health in order. Y'all wanting God to heal you from this and heal you from that, but you're still eating fried chicken. That's okay. I got me some chicken. I'm going to go fry to death. Right? You want God to heal you, but you're not doing what you need to do. You just want a miracle. You're not changing your eating habits. You're not exercising. You're not drinking water. You're not pushing away from the table. I see people I went to school with and grew up with and went to church with, and they still say, Jens, you are still so skinny. I say, no, it takes a lot of work. God is just not keeping me skinny. I have to put the work. I drink my water. I exercise. I do not overeat unless it's my birthday or Christmas or Thanksgiving or something like that or at a party. I watch what I eat. I eat very healthy. And I'm still overweight. I still need to lose 10 pounds. My point is, y'all, you got to give God something to work with. You want God to put money in your account? Malachi 3:10, bring you all the tithes into the storehouse. And test me and see if I will not open up the windows of heaven and give you a blessing that you will not have room enough to receive. But some of y'all don't even want to bring tithes and offering to the pastor. Some of you have watched my, I have been watching my video for years on YouTube. You get blessed, you get encouraged, and you have never planted a seed in my ministry. You have never bought a book. I have people emailing me when I say I'm going to give a free book, and I ask them, have you bought a book? And they tell me no. So I'm saying, I'm trying to say to myself, why should I give you a book? You've never planted in my ministry and in my YouTube. You've never, you haven't even bought a book. But you want me to give you a book? No. Y'all, we have to give some God something to work with. We're believing God for our house, for our forever home. Every morning I check the houses my realtor sent me, Felix. I drive through the community we want to live and look at signs. Soon as I see a sign, I text my realtor, hey, Felix, check this out. So if you want God to order your steps, first of all, you got to lift your foot up to step. And if you don't lift your foot up to step, how can God order your steps in his word? If you're not trying to push back from the table and stop overeating, how you expect God to help you with your health? They were talking about so many losing all that weight from that medicine, and there's a black doctor, and she said, well, I hope they plan on taking it for the rest of their lives, because if they don't, they're going to gain the weight back. We have to give God something to work with. You want God to work in your finances? Bring your tithes and offerings to the storehouse. You want God to bless you with a husband? Dress up, get up, and go out. Take the husband profile course the next time I teach it so you can learn how to date. You want God to bless your ministry? Plant in somebody else's ministry. Huh? You want people to bless you? Have you blessed somebody else? You have to give God something to work with. Take the cookie off the table. How you want a husband? You saw that thing I posted about the man talk about he was nutting in some woman a few months ago. Now she's engaged. Stop giving men access to your bodies. It all, if you think about it, all intertwines. I absolutely love you. I adore you. Order my steps in your way, Lord. Well, sweetie, you got to start stepping. You got to get up out of that bed. You got to seek the Lord. You got to read your Bible. You got to study. You have to seek his face. I love you. Bless and prosperous new year. I might not talk to y'all before this week again, because I'm going to take the week off. But I hope this word will encourage you and you will begin to do the work to step. Order my steps in your way, O Lord. God can't order your step until you lift up your foot. I got to go, girl. Love you. Talk to you later. Bye.